Dear students, we will continue the application of first law of thermodynamics. We studied that first law of thermodynamics has wide application. We applied the application of first law of thermodynamics isothermal process, adiabatic process, then isobaric process, isochoric process. Now we applied the first law of thermodynamics in change in internal energy during melting process. When a solid melt into liquid, its internal energy increases but temperature of the system remains constant. If m is the mass of solid, L latent heat of fusion of solid, then amount of heat required during melting process will be del Q is equal to M into L. L is latent heat of the solid, latent heat of fusion of solid, and M is the mass of the solid. When the substance melt, the change in the volume will be negligible. So dV is equal to zero. If dV is zero, then work done will be zero. For the first law of thermodynamics, we have del Q is equal to du plus del W. Del W is zero as the volume is negligible changes. So del Q is equal to du. Du is the change in the internal energy, or del Q will be during the melting process, M do L equal to D U. Hence, during melting process, the increase in internal energy is calculated from M dot L, latent heat of fusion or mass of the solid. Change in internal energy, next application, we apply the first law of thermodynamics in during boiling process. When a liquid boils, its liquid will convert in vapor form. So internal energy increase, but during the process the temperature remains constant and volume will increase. If M is the mass of liquid and L is latent heat of vaporization, then heat given to boiling process is equal to del Q is equal to ML, where M is the mass of liquid or L latent heat of vaporization. If initial volume is VI and final volume is VF, then change in volume is VF minus VI. From the first law of thermodynamics, we know del Q is equal to du plus PdV. डेल क्यू क्या होगा, एम डॉट एल इन बॉइलिंग प्रोसेस, इज इक्वल टू डी यू प्लस पी, और डी वी क्या निकाला हमने, वी एफ माइनस वी आई, हम यहां लिख देंगे वी माइनस वी आई. तो यहां से हम डीयू की वैल्यू निकाल सकते चेंज इन इंटरनल एनर्जी ड्यूरिंग बॉइलिंग प्रोसेस वाई नोइंग द एम एल पी वी आई एंड वी एफ. नेक्स्ट बाय यूजिंग द फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स वी विल कैलकुलेट रिलेशन बिटवीन सी पी एंड सी वी. What are Cp and Cv are specific heat at constant pressure and constant volume. By using the first law of thermodynamics, we will calculate relation between Cp, specific heat at constant pressure, and Cv, specific heat at constant volume. Let us consider one mole of an ideal gas having pressure P, volume V and temperature T and Cp is the molar specific heat of gas at constant pressure and Cv molar specific heat at constant volume. If del Q is the amount of heat given to the gas, then from the first law of thermodynamics, we have del Q is du plus del W. When heat is applied at constant volume, then del Q is equal to m dot Cv dot dt. Del Q is equal to m Cv dot dt. M number of moles that we have take initial 1 mole of gas. So del Q is equal to 1 dot Cv specific heat at constant volume dt change in temperature. At gas heated at constant volume, so work done will be equal to zero. Hence, we concluded Cv dot dt is equal to du. When heat is applied at constant pressure, then let us take 1 mole of gas at constant pressure to increase its temperature by dt, then del Q is equal to 1 into Cp dot dt. Let us say equation 1. As the heat supplied at constant pressure, temperature will increase by dt, or due to this, the du will be changed in internal energy. And del W is the total work done if volume change by dW. Del W will be equal to P dot D. From the first law of thermodynamics, we have dQ डेल क्यू इज इक्वल टू डी यू प्लस डेल डब्ल्यू. हेयर वी पुट पी डॉट डी वी, डी क्यू वी हैव डी अमाउंट ऑफ हीट एट कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर. सी पी डॉट डी टी इज इक्वल टू डी यू प्लस पी डॉट डी डब्ल्यू. प्रीवियसली व्हेन हीट इज सप्लाइड एट कॉन्स्टेंट वॉल्यूम वी कैलकुलेट डी U is equal to CV dot dT. Combining both the equation, we will get CP dot dT is equal to CV dot dT plus P dot dW. For one mole of a perfect gas, we have PV is equal to RT. As the heat is applied here at constant pressure, treating P as constant, we differentiate with respect to temperature, then we have P dot dV by dT is equal to R. Hence P dot dW is equal to R dot dT. Putting this value in previous equation, we will get CP dT is equal to CV dT plus R dT, and CP minus CV is equal to R. This is the relation between specific heat of gas, two principal specific heat of gas.